हाय फ्रेंड, माय नेम इज रुपेश कुमार। माय रोल नंबर इज 1906010024। टुडे इन दिस फोर्थ एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ सिग्नल एंड सिस्टम वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट कॉन्वोल्यूशन। हियर आवर एम इज टू कोड ए मैटलैब फंक्शन टू परफॉर्म ए लीनियर कॉन्वोल्यूशन ऑफ इनपुट डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिक्वेंस एंड इम्पल्स रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ द LTI डिस्क्रीट सिस्टम विद जीरो इनिशियल कंडीशन। Convolution is a mathematical operation for an LTI system. The convolution of input signal with the unit impulse response gives the output signal. Unit impulse response is the output of the system when the input is impulse signal. First, we are going to create the MATLAB function to perform the linear convolution of input discrete time. So here you can see here is a function which will perform the convolution. Here n equals to length of x, here x and h are inputs, n are the length of n, n is the total sum of n1 and n2, y is the 0 of 1 to total length n, and we have written for loop to perform the convolution. Next, we are going to find the impulse response of the flowing that is, which you can see it here. These are our system, and we will look at its impulse response. So, first, we have loaded the signals using the load, and let me run it. Here you can see the figure 1. These are the four input signals. And PPG. Next, we'll study the performance of all these systems in the SGPC. These are the real world signals. So, for the first system 1, you can see there are 4 systems. You will see its response. So, you can see these are the 4 response of the input system. So, this one for the first. Now we are going to start with the system 1. Here you can see our input system is H equal to 1 by 3. Let me run it. So you can see there are 4 bigger windows, and the first one is here. We are reconvolving the input signal and we got these results. Next, for the system 2, we have loaded the input signal and our input response is equal to 1 by n2. Here we are convolving all this input signal. So let me run it. So here it is asking the entry the value of let me enter 50. So for the m equal to 50, you can see these all are the outputs that signal are getting smoother. Allowed the only part the small frequency signal, and similarly for system 3, and the same for here, but here our impulse system is 1 and minus 1. Here we are convolving, so you can see its output. It's allowing only the higher frequency to pass. System is equal to 1 by 2, 0 and minus 2. At 0 and 2, let me run it. And you can see it is also a high filter pass system, which is only the high frequency pass. Next, we are going to see about it trained. So, now we are going to write about the operation of all these systems, input signals. So first one is low pass filter, as it's allowing on low frequency components left to pass. Second one is also low pass filter. Third one is high pass filter, and fourth one is high pass filter. To remove the trend, we are writing here the difference equation. You can see it here, and it removes the trend of the system. So let me rerun. Here I have written the code. Let me run the code. So it asks me the value. Let me enter 100. So here you can see that it is the output, and here trend has been removed, and it's already the signal as output. Now, at last, we are mentioning about the properties of the all these systems which we have seen. First one is noiseless, causes stable linear invariant. Second one is also linear invariant memory and stable causal. Third one is also linear invariant memory. Linear invariant, time invariant,